In this video, we are going to talk about user and permissions mapping, two of the main features offered by CB Dynamics 365 to SharePoint's Permissions Replicator. Log into your Saas portal account. Click Configuration and choose CB CRM SharePoint Permissions Replicator. For any configuration, you can view the user mapping by clicking the User Mapping button. At the top of this screen, you can see the number of users currently mapped, the number of user licenses available to you according to your active plan, and the number of user licenses that are in use. The service provides an out-of-the-box automated algorithm to match between users in Dynamics 365 and users in SharePoint. The algorithm uses login names to match users. Therefore, it is important that the linked CRM and SharePoint are both connected to the same Active Directory domain or Office 365 organization. As you can see, a couple of users are already mapped automatically. That's because the user mapping mode is set to Automatic Append. Any custom mapping you will perform will be appended to the auto mapping done by the service. You can edit and block any of the mappings here. To map between a CRM user and a SharePoint user, click the Edit button from the row for that CRM user. Choose a SharePoint user. And click Save and Close. The Custom Mapping column indicates that the mapping is a user-defined mapping. To delete that custom mapping that we just created, click Delete. To block any mapping, simply click the Block button. By doing so, the user will not consume a license. The Mapped column identifies the status of the mapping. A check mark indicates that the user is mapped and the mapping is active. An exclamation mark indicates that the CRM user is not mapped to a SharePoint user. And a no symbol indicates that the mapping is blocked. To unblock a previously blocked mapping, simply click the Delete button. If you wish to fully override the automatic mapping and use your own mappings, click the Change button next to User Mapping Mode. Choose the Manual Replace option and click Save. You will notice that the auto mappings were cleared, allowing you to map the users according to your own business rules. Changing the User Mapping Mode to Automatic Append will restore the auto mapping that we saw earlier, while still preserving the custom mappings that we created. Now let's talk about permissions mapping. Let's go back to the main configuration screen. Click Configuration and choose CB CRM SharePoint Permissions Replicator. Click the Permissions Mapping button to view the permissions mapping. Dynamics 365 and SharePoint security models differ. Mapping between them is required. The application has pre-configured mappings between Dynamics 365 and SharePoint that will be suitable for most deployments. CB Replicator automatically creates dedicated permission levels in the target SharePoint, CB Replicator CRM Read Access, and CB Replicator CRM Write Access. The CRM Read Access write is mapped to a permission level called CB Replicator CRM Read Access, which grants the user on the SharePoint the right to view list items, open items, and other actions that are mentioned here. Similarly, the CRM Write Access write is mapped to a permission level called CB Replicator CRM Write Access, which grants the user on SharePoint the right to add list items, edit list items, and other actions that are mentioned here. As you can see, the permission mapping mode is set to Automatic Append. That means any custom mapping you create will be appended to the auto mapping done by that service. Let's say, for example, that users with Delete Access Right in CRM should be granted Contribute permission in SharePoint. To achieve this business requirement, we click the Create New button to create a new permission mapping. Choose Delete Access from the CRM Access Rights list. Choose Contribute from the SharePoint Permissions Level list. We could click Save Now, which makes this permission mapping global to all entities. Or we could restrict this permission mapping to a specific entity, for example, accounts. We click Save and Close to save this mapping. If you wish to have your own custom mapping and clear the auto mapping done by the service, click the Change button next to the permission mapping mode. Choose Manual, Replace, and click Save. You will notice that the custom mappings are kept while the auto mappings are cleared. We could, for example, map the CRM Read Access right to the SharePoint Read permission. And the CRM Write Access right at any time. You can switch back to the automatic append mode. You can edit any custom mapping you created earlier. You may also delete any previously created custom mapping. Great! So in this video, we've discussed user mapping and permissions mapping provided by CB Dynamics CRM SharePoint Permissions Replicator. If you have any questions, please do get in touch. We would love to assist you. Our contact info is in the description below. And thank you for watching.